Hello, it is Gem Warrior, and I'm so exhausted. Okay, it is time for week 13 of the YouTube Pagan Challenge, and this week's topic is divination question mark. Like, do you have it? Do you use it? What does it mean to you? And yes, I do use divination. I think we pretty much all use divination in some form, and yeah, like most people, I do use like cards. So trying to reach them. Ugh, if I don't break everything in the process. But crisis averted. But yes, I do, and I use cards, and I use like Oracle cards. So this is a deck that I very much love. And that's the Wisdom of Avalon Oracle deck, because I work with a lot of Avalonian deities. Goddess Guidance, which is like amazing. And yes, they are by Doreen Virtue, who is a little controversial. I made a two-parter video on these. I loved them so much where I went through every single card. And then of course, I also made a video about my first tarot card purchase finally. I've been practicing paganism for what, 12, 13 years now, and I've never gotten a tarot deck. I always went to other forms of divination, but I finally got one. Justice League Tarot. By DC Comics, of course, that's what made me finally give in, because I was like, comic book related tarot. Yes, I will. So I got that. And then of course my favorite form of divination is the Ogham, which I also made a video on. So I guess by me saying that I'm making videos on all these, obviously I like divination, it's important to me. But Ogham or Celtic is a Celtic divination system. It's just scripts like etchings on sticks, and they all have meanings that are related to plants and trees, with metaphorical meanings for said plants and trees. And then I also made a video in my hoodoo video about casting the bones or throwing the bones and stuff like that. So there's like dice and shells. A pendulum is actually in here too. Stones and all kinds of things, and you interpret from that how they fall and everything. So I do that a lot. I also do bibliomancy, where you open up a book and you divine from that. However, even though I just showed all those forms of divination, and I said that Ogham's my favorite, and that I do all those, which I do, by far and away, the most common form of divination that I do on a daily basis is just observance and analyzation, divining from nature, from like the world around me. So like animals and plants. Like I'll watch the activity of animals, and I look at plants and how they've grown and the shapes that they take in and things like that. And that's really mostly where I do most of my divination. Of course, like dreams and everything. I'm pretty much open to any form of divination there is, and I will dabble accordingly. But definitely the observance of just my surroundings is where I get the most out of my divinatory practice, I guess. Divination is so important to us. I feel like it's like one of the 101s, of paganism. Like we all pretty much do it. And it's so important. But I do kind of want to address the idea that, sometimes people are like, oh, I can't read myself. I just can't read myself. And I think that that's a load of bullcrap, actually. I think there is a partial truth to it, because we do all have trouble reading ourselves, I think. But it's kind of bullcrap to just straight up say that you can't. You can. I think the more shadow work that you do, the easier it becomes to read yourself, because you have a more accurate view of yourself. I think that a lot of the times we have this light only, or like romanticized idea of who we are and what we look like and the kind of people that we are. We only see ourselves in the good aspects of ourselves, and it takes another person sometimes to show us our shadow and to show us the things that we need to work on, etc. Which is what comes out a lot of the time in divination. However, I do think that it is possible to read yourself. And as I said, oh, look, my computer just did an update. But as I said, I think that the more shadow work that you do, the more of an accurate view of yourself that you get, and the easier it is to then divine for yourself. I'm a big, like a big supporter of independence and like being able to do everything yourself, as much as possible, at least. And for me, that includes a lot of magical practice. I think doing your own readings and healings and stuff on yourself is ridiculously important and empowering. Just like paying your bills on your own and, you know, like living on your own. But divination, you know, it does pull things from our subconscious that we are hiding from ourselves or that we genuinely do not know. And I think that divination also pulls things from outside of us that we don't know about and that we need help with. But it's vastly important. I think it's inseparable from paganism. I really do. And I love all of its forms, really. There's not been one that I've been like, nope, not going to do that. Except for maybe the one that the ancient like Romans did, where they would like divine through like intestines. Like, I guess I wouldn't want to really do that. But for the most part, you get what I'm saying. I'm open to all forms of divination, and I love divination. And those are the forms that I love. Ogham and like nature, mostly. But that's it, you guys, for this week for me. I hope wherever you are, you are well. Namaste and Oshé. Peace out, Girl Scouts.